Really, when the khilone wala comes, that time children becomes happy. But Mini becomes happy when Kabuliwala comes. Today we will read the story of Kabuliwala. Kabuliwala is a story written by Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore got Nobel Prize of Literature in 1913, and story Kabuliwala has been written by him. Let's read the story. Mini was 5 years old. She could not live without chattering. In all her life, she had not wasted a minute in silence. One morning, Mini entered her father's room and said, "Father, Ram Dayal, the doorkeeper, calls a crow crow. He doesn't know anything." Before her father could explain it, she asked him, "What do you think, father?" "Bhola says there is an elephant in the clouds, blowing water out of his trunk, and that is why it rains." Father wanted to reply, but she said, "Father, what relation is mother to you?" Father replied the last question and said, "Go and play with Bhola." "Mini, I am busy." Suddenly, Mini left her play and ran to the window, crying, "A Kabuliwala, a Kabuliwala." Actually, a Kabuliwala was passing in the street. He wore loose clothes with a tall turban. There was a bag on his back and he carried boxes of grapes in his hand. Mini was frightened. She had a blind belief that inside the bag there were perhaps 2 or 3 children like herself. The peddler, meanwhile, entered the house with a smiling face. He asked Mini's father, "Where is the little girl, sir?" Father thought Mini must get rid of her false fear and brought her out. Mini looked at the Kabuliwala and his bag. The Kabuliwala offered her nuts and raisins. After that, it became a routine work for both Mini and the Kabuliwala to meet and talk. Mini had got a good listener. The Kabuliwala would give her almonds and raisins. They had become friends, although there was a great difference in their age. One day, Rahmat, the Kabuliwala, had a quarrel with a person who had denied to pay his money. In the course of the quarrel, Rahmat struck him. He was caught by the police and sent to jail. Time passed away. Mini forgot her old friend. New companions filled her life. As she grew older, she spent more of her time with girls. Years had passed away. Father had made arrangement for Mini's marriage. Mini was to be married that night. Father was busy when someone entered his room and saluted him. Father recognized him and asked, "When did you come?" "Rahmat, last evening," he said, "I was released from jail." Father said, "There are ceremonies going on and I am busy. Could you perhaps come another day?" At once, he turned to go out, but as he reached the door, he hesitated and said, "May I not see the little one, sir, for a moment?" It was his belief that Minnie was still the same. He had brought a few almonds and raisins and grapes. Father said again, "There is a ceremony in the house and you will not be able to see anyone today." Rahmat said, I brought these few things, sir, for the little one. Will you give them to her? I too have one like her in my house. I think of her and bring fruits to your child." He shoved a piece of paper. There was the impression of his daughter's ink-smeared hand. He had kept it as a memory of his little daughter. Tears came to the eyes of Minnie's father. He immediately sent for Minnie. Clad in the red silk of her wedding day, Minnie came and stood before them. The Kabuliwala looked at her. He could not revive his old friendship. Even Minnie could not talk to her as of old. Rahmat heaved a deep sigh and sat down on the floor. The idea had suddenly come to him that his daughter too must have grown in this long time. Minnie's father took out a bank note and gave it to him, saying, "Go back to your own daughter Rahmat in your country." Minnie's father was happy that in a distant land a long lost father would meet again with his only child. Rabindranath Tagore. Thank you. Have a nice day.